Well, going into the race, my game plan is always, you know, paddle as hard as I can and don't leave anything on the beach. You know, like, it's only an hour and a half of your life, so just put it all 100%. And it's so symbolic that I was able to go out there. Like, if my life was a race, that was it right there, you know.
Yeah, it was brutal. I mean, being right next to another person means you have to sprint the whole time. It's not like you can cruise or anything. So the whole time me and Slater were battling it out, it was crazy. And then I just got a lucky wave and got in front, which was a heartbreak, or not a heartbreak, just a heart relief. Just, oh, it was super nice and great.
I just know how good, everyone knows how good Danny is. And I just said to myself, I'm just going to hang with the guy as long as I can. That's my plate. I wasn't going to try and lead. I was just going to hang. And I just thought, I'm going to try and get lucky or just really have a push or just do something different on the last lap. And, like, you know, be told I got lucky on the wave. It seriously was. And then once you get lucky, you know, you just hammer. He would have done the same thing. Happened last year pretty much around the same time in the race. Different course, of course. But and once you get in front, you know, adrenaline, it's hard to come from behind when you've just done, like, an hour of just torture.
Well, you know, we've been doing this for years on everything. And for the most part, it's no surprise. We see it coming 6 months in advance. We get here, we race together the whole way, and I'm pretty sure it was almost exactly the same leg last year where I was in the right spot and I got lucky. But you know what, I have a feeling it's going to happen a little more, and those two young boys behind us are probably going to come in and mix it up a little bit.